Hi guys, we're back again. Happy Halloween. I've got my spooky nails on my 5-minute mani where I did my little pumpkins and my little So that's a reason for the crazy nails. It actually is Halloween day. But being in the true spirit of staying ahead for the projects, I have a Christmas project to show you on Halloween. So here is my boxed mini, and this is the first box mini my pattern that I've done out of Christmas paper, and I use the little yellow bicycle. I use the Making Merry, and I used 5 sheets of the 12 by 12, and I used about half the pack, maybe a little more than half the pack of the 6 by 6, and I also used some of the journaling cards. And I use some of the, I think these are called ornaments, tags with string, journaling cards. And for the top here, this flower was made with the paper crafting kit, which has some cute little banners in here. This is all that's left over. Quite a bit left over. There's a lot in these packs. And I also used almost this entire sticker sheet, and it's the cardstock stickers. And I backed them on thick chipboard myself and cut them out. Oh, and here's another little flower that I made that I didn't get a chance to use, but isn't it cute? So you won't be seeing this one inside because there's not really, I couldn't find a good place to put it, but that was made out of that same pack, this one right here, and there's still enough to make more flowers too. So let me show you how cute this is, a little yellow bicycle. And look at how cute this little flower came out, and it's all pre-scored and super easy to put together, and it's got some little holly, paper holly coming out here. And they come with the brads, and then I used a little bit of ribbon to make it look like a present. Sorry, I'm like all over the place with this. But I love this black, the chalkboard. Actually, it's more of a charcoal than gray than black. But it looks so cute. So it looks like a little present, all boxed up, ready to gift. And so there it is. There's the outside. Look at the little Christmas wishes here. Super cute. I really like the way this one came out. Let's see. And so we open it up. And here we go. And it opens up. And we've got this pretty gray and a nice red floral pattern. And over here, I cut out one of the new Tim Holtz ornate frames. That's one of his new Biggs dies, and I cut it out of black chipboard, and then I heat embossed it with Wow Glitz, black glitz, which is kind of like a glitter embossing powder. And then these are two of the little pieces that came out of, I think it was this pack, and then I just put them onto chipboard. But you can see how, it just takes a regular die cut, and it really adds to it when you add it to a chipboard. And I just cut it out with my Timmy scissors, just glued it on there and cut it out of my scraps. So over here we have, I'm going to have to keep on bringing this up because I want you to be able to read it and see the whole page. So we have It's the Most Wonderful Time of the Year, and then this little snowflake is on chipboard. So actually it's three layers of this is not chipboard, this is three layers of black tag board glued together because I used a punch to punch that out, and of course I can't punch through thick chipboard. But I kept this side pretty mellow with the with only a tiny little piece of chipboard because I have all of these dimensional chipboards on this side, so I didn't want them to rub up against one another and wear. There's enough room in the depth for this one. And this is also a modification on my first one because this is now a 6-page mini, whereas my original design was 8-page. And it's also a little bit taller. And in order to accommodate a wider binding, so you can get more dimensional on your pages. I think I'm going to have a modification pattern, a supplemental to, I don't know if it's going to be supplemental, as an add-on to my existing pattern, or if it's going to be a whole new pattern with a couple different variations in it. So, but that should be coming within the next couple weeks, so keep a lookout for that. Oh, I forgot. Out of each one of these pulls a little tag, and look at how cute. Look at little Holly. Such cute chalkboard paper. And then on these, instead of using binding strips, this paper creased well. This little yellow bicycle creased well. So I was able to just add in an extra 5/8 of an inch and use an EK Success punch and give a nice border and attach it at the same time. So of course that flips up here and then these flip up again here. So lots of opportunities for full-size photos on the inside. And then this turns over and we have a holly jolly Christmas. Oop, hello. Hello, camera. There you go. Oh, I'm gonna have to sneeze. Okay, maybe not. Again, this has popped up on chipboard. You can see nice and thick. It's got some great dimension to it. It adds a lot to the page. It transfers. You can really, it really makes a difference more in person. But look at these. So this is a little 6x6 page that I cut the bottom 2 inches off, and I matched up the frames. So there's a way that you can use a piece of 6x6 with a frame around it and still have it look right is by turning it into a pocket. And then here I added a little bit of a sticker element that says Magic of Christmas. And here's Deck the Halls. This was part of the sticker elements, and I put it on chipboard, of course, just like everything. And these are some of these little tags. And here are some of the journalings. And look at this one with the little notebook punch on the top. Isn't that cute? Look at that little guy. Super cute. So yeah, so we got little pockets on here, and there are three of these little pockets. I think I'm gonna put that one back there. And then this one pulls out. Cute paper. So yeah, using the 6x6 on here really helped to again, there's that same I think it's called Jewels. It's something to do with Jewels by EK Success, is that punch. I think that the 6x6 pattern was definitely the right scale for this project. And then over here, we have this page. You can see the hole. And over here, we have this one that says Believe up on chipboard. That same punch along here, and it flips out kind of like my secret garden version. And look at these cute little red snowflakes. Let's see if it'll focus in on that. And then over here, we have this pretty damask gray and white. And then this little joy that I made that little rosette from that flower pack. And again, here's one of the stickers, and it's glued onto some thick chipboard. That closes off. And then we have another insert here. So cute. And look at that cute plaid. Isn't that sweet? So yeah, lots of room for full-size photos on the inside. And then on this one, I just love the Christmas wishes one. Isn't that cute? So cute. I left the little stickers on the flags. I didn't want to turn all of them into little fishtail ends. And here we have another one of those that is a pocket. Oh, I can hold it up here. We've got again Merry Christmas. This has got a little bit of shine. It's got a little bit of heat embossing around this rectangle, and then I glued it all to some more chipboard to pop it up. And then we've got a little bit of a sticker sheet right on the top of the pocket. And then we have memories, and look how cute that little cut edge is. Great, little yellow bicycle. I've never really been a huge fan of them, but wow, their elements are just awesome. They're really fun. It makes making, look at this one, it's journaling. I don't know if you, it's very, very faint. But it does have journaling on there. The memories one does too. But their elements are just so awesome. It makes putting a mini together so quick. So quick. And then I don't think I showed this one. But look at the little happy holidays. Oh, and it says on here somewhere, merry everything. Or happy everything. It's really kind of funny. And then the reverse of this is that pretty red and white scroll. And that same punch. And get back in there. And then over here, we have, this is my favorite sheet. This is the 6x6 of what I put on the top. And it says, being together is the best gift of all, which I love. And then again, we have another one of these flip out and says, no peeking. I love that. I love that it says no peeking on the interactive part. So it's like you're being, you know, you're peeking. I know, silly. But, you know, that's what it's all about, right? Being silly keeps you young. Cute little gray snowflake, and it's got a little bit of red and green mixed in there. Really interesting pattern. And this one is a little holly, if you can see that. Maybe. There you go. No peeking. And again, all these are on chipboard, because I love me some chipboard. And here's the tag for this one, the booklet. And then it's got the larger print of that same holly. This is from the 12x12 sheet, and the same punched edge. And then over here, we have Jingle All the Way. Look at that great stripe. That's the 6x6 version of the stripe that I used on the outside of the box, but again, popped up on the chipboard. And then we've got our third pocket page. And this is part of the paper, and this one is a sticker popped up on the chipboard. And we've got some tags in here with a Merry Christmas, celebrate, and it's got its lines going this way. Again, these are really, really faint. I mean, you can see the snowflakes on there, but you can't hardly see, or at least I can't see it in the camera. And this one, you can see the lines. But very faint, subtle lines that are really nice. Okay, I'm going to put this one straight up and down. These tags are just the right size for these little pockets. So they have to be under 4 inches to fit. And then we've got this pretty gray and white snowflake. And it's got the stripes going horizontally. That same punched edge. And then we're at our back page. And it says the joy of Christmas, and this is popped up on Pop Dots, if you can see there. And over here we have our third flip out page, and look, here's a little love chipboard element. I put that on the chipboard, glued that on. That's another sticker, I believe. It could have been one of the elements though from the flower pack. But same punched edge, and then we've got this red and white kind of candy cane stripe. Well, I wouldn't say it's a candy cane, but reminds me of candy cane. It's not diagonal. But yeah, so there it is. So there is my Christmas mini, boxed mini. And let me go ahead and zoom out if I can. And, well, now you get to see the mess of my desk, but there you go. There's the whole thing laid out. And I'll flip back through. Oop, I'm taking 2 pages at a time on that one. So I really like the way this one came out. And I will be teaching this at the Little Blue House in Keller, Texas. And so if you're local, you know, give them a call, and we'll be teaching this November 9th. So it is only about a week away, and so I've got to go drop this off in the store right away, within the hour. So if you guys are local, then look them up. Look up the Little Blue House, and they also have a website, so you can do littlebluehouse.com. Super cute store. And thanks for watching, guys, and happy Halloween.